Welcome everyone. My name is Pavel Balsam. I'm associate professor at the Warsaw Medical University, head of electrophysiology department of the University Teaching Hospital. I had a pleasure to cooperate with artificial intelligence for monitoring of the ECG. And we have recently published a paper which is called The Use of Machine Learning Algorithms in the Evaluation of the Effectiveness of Resynchronization Therapy, which was published in the Journal of Cardiovascular Development and Disease. The artificial intelligence is becoming more and more popular in cardiovascular medicine in interpretation of the ECG and also interpretation of the images which we produce, for example, during the coronary angiography with the use of intravascular ultrasonography or optical coherent tomography. In case of the ECG signals, the artificial intelligence is known for a couple of years for diagnosing atrial fibrillation or some other supraventricular tachyarrhythmias. But our idea was to use it for the patients with implanted cardiac resynchronization therapy, so the patients with heart failure. And this condition is very challenging in terms of clinical management because those are patients who have got a high risk of sudden cardiac death and also high risk of decrease of the exercise tolerance, and especially patients who are candidates for cardiac resynchronization. Those are patients who will have a lot of success because of having this cardiac resynchronization if it will work properly. So we need to have a tool to evaluate the effectiveness of the cardiac resynchronization. Till now, we could only use the ECG and that interpretation by the cardiologist, by the physician, to look at the ECG and say there is a resynchronization or there is no resynchronization. And we could also do it with the Holter ECG monitoring, but still it needed a lot of work from the physician because we need to evaluate each beat of the patient. So we decided to use the artificial intelligence to try to recognize if there is a resynchronization or not. So we evaluated 1,241 ECG tracings which were collected from 547 patients, cardiac patients from our department. All ECG's signals were analyzed by three independent cardiologists. Every signal, every QRS complex from the Holter monitoring and from the ECG. So imagine that there were thousands of those QRS complexes were manually classified by the medical team and fully reviewed by additional cardiologists. And those results were divided into two groups. 80% of them we used to train the algorithm, and 20% were used to test to test this artificial intelligence system from cardiomatics system. So what we found that the detection sensitivity of the effective cardiac resynchronization was achieved by 99.2% by this algorithm, by this artificial intelligence, and the precision was 92.4%. And now we can say what will be the usage of this solution in the future. How can we use it for our patients? Firstly, we have thousands of people, of patients with cardiac resynchronization at this moment, and we'll have much more of them because we know that heart failure is one of the diseases that will be increasing in numbers in the following years because the population is getting older and we have got more patients who survived myocardial infarction. So this will be the usage, this will be the place for this artificial intelligence. If the patient will receive the cardiac resynchronization, we can use it to check if it works properly. Because sometimes we can adjust the settings of the device to increase the number of resynchronized QRS complexes. And what we want to achieve is to have almost 100% of the QRSs which are resynchronized in our patient. What is the future in the context of the introduction of the innovations which will optimize the work of our doctors? We need this one. We need artificial intelligence and checking the results of our patients because we will have more and more older patients who will have more and more diseases. And we've got a lot of raw data which are now coming to us. We've got in every patient, with every cardiac patient, we've got the laboratory tests, we've got the ECGs, we've got the long-term monitoring. More and more countries are now using 30 days monitoring with some vests or with some patches which are connected with the body of the patient. So those are a lot of data. 30 days of monitoring of patients is a lot to do to check it by the cardiologist or by the physician. So automatic algorithms, which will be looking at this one, will be very helpful for us to have the final diagnosis. Same thing with all of the CT scans, MRI scans, SPECTs, positron emission tomography. So all of the imaging, which is used a lot of in cardiology, this will also need the help of artificial intelligence, because right now we've got the problem with radiologists. There are not too many of them, and we are waiting a lot of time for the procedure to be done, for the diagnostic procedure, and then we'll wait a lot of time to receive the final result. If there would be a help of artificial intelligence, we could decrease the time what we need to achieve those results from the imaging, and then we could also make the decisions for our patients much faster. So I think there is a future of the artificial intelligence for us, for doctors, and also for patients. It should be used as a tool. It cannot work, it cannot be the thing that will exclude the doctor. It should be done together with our work, with our normal daily work, as a helpful tool to set the final diagnosis and then to decide what kind of procedures, what kind of treatment should we choose for our patient. Thank you very much for your attention, and see you next time in the next newsletter.